Hello, and welcome to Our Kids, brought to you by the Jefferson County Public Schools. I'm Ballard High School correspondent, Maddie Sennett. It's been a great year so far, and this April, we have stories about high schoolers connecting at the JCPS Idea Festival, an international delegation visiting St. Matthew's Elementary, a J-Town student taking his skills to a local business, and a pioneering rap artist sharing his talents. Plus, we have more from our student correspondents.
Here at Wilt, JCPS students are giving back to their community.
Raising awareness for women's issues. I'm Ballard correspondent Julia Koenig, and I'll have the story.
Students at Fairdale High School have the opportunity to have hands-on experiences every day thanks to the HES program.
More than 600 students gathered at Spalding University for the 2017 JCPS Idea Festival. This year's event focused on the theme of connectivity.
JCPS Idea Festival, which is a completely student-run, student-led organization. There are a series of presentations from students all across the district. We have people from Manual, from Fairdale, from Fern Creek, from Central. And today is just a day for students to share their ideas and empower them to know that their voices should be heard too.
My message is pretty simple. Listen to us. We can help solve problems if you let us.
IdeaFest is basically different kids from all over the district just coming together and presenting topics that interest them.
Let that music take you back to that experience you were thinking of, and were you fully able to experience that emotion once again?
Speak the truth without double hesitation is love in the life that is of her own creation. Why? Because she is a woman.
She, it's like a woman empowerment piece, and it really speaks volumes on the inequality women is facing today within the media and society. And I really want that piece as well to get people moving and get people riled up to fight for justice for them as well.
She's an assassin of idealism, where it's okay to not believe in monogamy, where honestly she's the prodigy of her own life lived consciously, yet the hypocrisy of patriarchy is just marginalized ferocity holding us back from finally putting a comma on this thing called life and philosophy, so we can just be women. Thank you.
I see it as basically a safe haven for everybody to share their opinions, their ideas about life, about anything in the world. And I really feel like it's a place for people to bond and connect, as that's our theme this year, on the power of their minds.
My favorite part about the day is the conversations that students get to have with the other students. They get to meet people from schools across the district that they wouldn't interact with otherwise. And whenever people of different backgrounds with these same ideas come together, it's really powerful.
You have so many different people from all over the city and the state coming together and talking about so many different things. Change can't happen unless you talk about it. And so the community and the city can't improve unless you have people discussing it and people bringing up things that other people don't want to address.
You all have talked a lot about your experiences in the classroom, and Jack and Pearl, you all have felt the need to really make an emphasis on student voice. So
we are the future, and if we're over here developing ideas and trying to make change for the future, why would you want to put that down? Students coming together and producing different ideas to make the future better.
Have the courage to find your voice. Speak up, but do it with facts. Do it respectfully. Speak out knowing that it's your education, your life, your future.
I really feel it's important for especially the younger generation to be able to do that in a free and open space. So when they do grow up and become like the leaders of the world, that they know that their opinions matter.
They need to know that they don't have to wait until they're grown up or in college or in the workforce to share their ideas. We need to empower our students through our education system today and let them know that they can make a change.
A delegation from Quebec, Canada, visited St. Matthew's Elementary School. The deputy premier spoke with students and staff about international school partnerships and global outreach.
Toi, comment ça va? Bien, ça va mal, comme ci, comme ça?
Ça va bien.
Ça va bien.
Ouais. The reason we're in St. Matthew's today is very simple. About a year ago, we decided to make a relationship between primary schools in the United States and primary schools, public schools in Quebec, and get the students, the teachers, the principals, and the parents involved in the two states to really connect and have some relationship so that we can, the kids here can explain to the kids in Quebec what's going on in Kentucky and vice versa.
Earlier this year, we started a partnership with Quebec.
Why we speak French? Why it's so important?
And it's also a partnership because of the global economy and trying to get our students to realize how important having connections and learning about other cultures, how that can benefit you today and also when you go into the workforce. So getting somebody that is a natural French speaker to come and talk to our class was a great learning experience for our students. And we had some gifts for them, and I had the student delegates present some of those gifts to them, and they were super excited. They got their pictures made with them.
Well, it's wonderful to, first of all, as you walk in a class in a foreign country and you're welcome in your language, because as you probably know, in Quebec, French is the official language. It's really exciting and touching, very touching. And then the minister was able to interact with the kids, and we were very impressed with the way the teacher was doing her class.
Merci.
Merci. But just the feeling and just the fact to talk about what's going on somewhere else in the world is opening the minds of the kids, and clearly that goal has been achieved right here in St. Matthew's.
Correspondent Alexis Harding visited Will Elementary to see how they are using penny wars to raise funds for children in hospitals.
The recently added student government at Will Elementary is giving back to their community. Students organized a penny war to raise money to get toys for kids in hospitals.
Well, we were in our student government meeting, and we were talking about what mattered most to us, and we had already done a food drive and an animal shelter drive where we collected food for the animals and blankets and towels where we donated them to the animal shelter so the animals wouldn't be cold. And so we were talking about what mattered most to us, and we were like, well, why don't we give back to like the people in the hospital that don't really get to go places.
Fourth grade teacher Molly Stella oversees the student government.
So first we helped with some donations for the animal shelter, and we also helped for a Dare to Care food drive. So I asked the students what was most important to them, and they said helping other kids. So we decided to do a penny war for the whole school.
Students brought in money every day for their class. The winning class will win a popcorn party next week. The money was collected and counted by student council members.
And so far, in just 2 days, we've collected over $500. So I've been really proud of all the students here at Wilt.
It makes me feel awesome.
Peaceful.
Good.
Ownership.
Caring.
Helpful.
Great.
Happy.
Really awesome. Like, we're making some kind of difference in the world.
JCPS students are not only learning, but are giving back. For our kids, I'm Fern Creek correspondent Alexis Harding.
A group of students from Ballard High School took a trip to Washington, D.C. to visit the National Museum of African American History and Culture. Correspondent Brittany Wilson brings us the story.
Students in Ballard's African American Literature class took a field trip of a lifetime. The goal was to see the Smithsonian Museum for African American History and Culture in our nation's capital.
The amazing opportunity to go on a trip with my African American literature class at Ballard High School to Washington, D.C. The first day we visit the new Smithsonian for African American Culture and History, and that was my favorite part of the entire trip. From the basement all the way up to the fourth floor, and we ate at the amazing cafe, and we had a great time looking at our history all the way up to the present in our culture right now. My second favorite part of the trip was our bus tour. We visited different monuments, statues, and capitals all around Washington, D.C. We were able to see the White House. And also on our Saturday, we got to visit the Capitol and tour that.
This was definitely a trip to remember. I'm Ballard correspondent Brittany Wilson for Our Kids.
We have a lot more stories about Our Kids coming up. Stay with us.
I'm neurosurgeon Shadriwala, Seneca High School class of 1989. I am JCPS.
I'm Ballard High School junior Brianna Owens, and I've been selected for the Wharton School of Business Summer Institute. I am JCPS.
I'm Marshall Goldsmith, Valley High School class of 1967. Executive Leadership Coach, I am JCPS.
I'm Justin Cornwell, Eastern High School class of 2007, and I played a young Muhammad Ali. I am JCPS.
We are JCPS.
The portal is your online link to information about your child's grades, test scores, attendance, career choices, and much, much more. It's a fast and easy way to stay on top of what your child is doing in school. If your child's teacher has set up a virtual classroom, you can log on to JCPS Online and access grades for class assignments or communicate directly with teachers. The Parent Portal offers a convenient way you can stay involved in your child's education.
Welcome back. You're watching Our Kids, sponsored by the Jefferson County Public Schools. I'm Ballard correspondent Maddie Sennett. Brandon Colin, a student from Jeffersontown High School, is taking the skills he learned in the classroom and using them in the real world. He is co-oping at the local printing company, Ink on Tap.
So is that the right size?
The artwork?
My name is Brandon Colon. I go to Jeffersontown High School. I'm in the CAD program there, and I'm currently co-oping as a junior for Ink on Tap. And currently, I am working on the laser engraver here, creating products for local companies. I'm about to focus the laser to make sure that the product or this cup is 3 inches away from the laser head. Basically, there's a laser tube in the back, and it bounces off some mirrors, and it shoots down into the middle, and it etches into whatever product you're engraving on.
Being a graduate of Jakestown High School and knowing about the trade program training that they have there, that it was really important to me to have an opportunity for somebody to come in here to be a part of what they want to learn and what we, you know, need employees for. And of course, once we met Brandon and saw that the training that he had, and it just spoke volumes about what they're learning at the school.
If I wasn't in the CAD program, I wouldn't have this job. So with the CAD program at Jakestown, it has taught me everything I need to know to get this job and be able to do what I need to do here to work.
So there it is.
I'm learning how to manufacture, how to, you know, get new clientele and stuff like that. Todd had to have a lot of trust in me to be able to use this equipment because it is really expensive to use and, you know, upkeep and stuff like that. And basically he took a chance on me and I took a chance coming here to come work.
The training that he received up there showed up immediately. I mean, you know, you're judging a new employee right off the bat, and you're evaluating to see what their capabilities are, and the training he's received and the way he carries himself and the confidence in knowing how to run that machine, like I said before, it just speaks volumes to the school. It really wasn't a hard decision. I mean, of course, we worked side by side with Brandon at first to see what his skill sets were, but he had a lot of them when he came here, so it was just, you know, it was a no-brainer.
It's really fun because now my days feel a lot shorter, even though I'm only leaving 2 periods earlier, but my days are shorter. I come here, I get to do what I like to do, create new things, and put, you know, my thoughts into action, like I said earlier, and basically to be able to do what I like doing. You know, I do come to challenges with designing new things. If, you know, certain logos don't look right, I have to go in and fix them. Or if the machine isn't working, I have to go into the manual and figure out how to fix it or figure it out myself.
Which, you know, we care about his future and we want to challenge him to learn more things and continue his education and give him the opportunities in life that we all are looking for. You have to take a chance on our youth, and if they're showing the effort at school to learn, I think it's a win-win all the way around. It's just been a great find for us, and I would not hesitate again to giving somebody another chance, especially with the co-op program.
Yeah, it seems like perfect size.
PRP High School's media department hosted a coding camp for students at Eisenhower Elementary. The kids had fun while learning some innovative skills.
100%.
We are here at PRP High School and our students are holding a fundraiser and it is a code camp.
What it really is just a way to get kids into technology and towards going towards an engineering job.
We have 9 students here from Eisenhower for the day and they are coding. They're using the computers to code, and we also have Dash, the robot.
It helps you in science. I asked my parents about coding. They said it's like robots, like robotics. You can make a robot do anything that you always want to, and I thought I could do that.
I'm interested in it because it means that, like, if you learn about it now, then you won't have a problem with it later, and you can create really cool things.
This is actually a fundraiser for us to go to STN, or Student Television Network, in California this spring.
Our advanced media students are going to the Student Television Network competition at the end of March. It's in Anaheim, California. So we have been fundraising for a lot of months now, putting together, trying to make sure that everything is paid up.
Hi, say hi. Yeah. You can say hi.
Try to get them to work towards putting in code, try to make it do whatever they want, and just kind of have fun experience with it.
So how would you complete the rest of the shape?
We set up multiple games for them to play, have little activities for them. Overall, just make it a fun learning experience for everybody.
Whistle? Dizzy. Yes, I want to see Dizzy.
We were having fun with, like, making the robot dance and, like, it flashing its lights and it going, like, doing the moonwalk and stuff.
I think it's good for them to start learning in elementary school because it actually gives them an idea of how engineering can work early on and actually help them focus on what they want to do in life.
There's so many things in our life that use code. Anything that we do other than turning a light switch on, anything that has a computer behind it, a chip somewhere in it, almost everything that is man-made at this point has some kind of code.
In code, you have to write out these special commands with symbols, letters, and numbers. But with this blockly thing, all the code is put into these little blocks that's easier to understand.
And it's really important for these guys because there's going to be some aspect in almost every job in the future that's going to have some kind of code.
It's actually a very fun, hands-on experience. Yes, it takes out of our time, but this is supposed to be our parent-teacher conference day, but still. Most of us would be just sitting at home, playing on our phones, doing nothing. Well, instead, we actually decided to come here and actually help somebody learn. I'm pretty sure that's a better experience for anybody who'd be willing to do this.
Correspondent Molly Wright shows us how the Fairdale High School's Heavy Equipment Science Program is preparing students for the future.
The Heavy Equipment Science Program at Fairdale High School is a very special program that takes advanced skill and teamwork. Students in this program learn a great deal and serve their community at the same time through some well-thought-out, real-world projects. For example, the students are putting their new knowledge and skills to good use by actually building a soccer field for their school. They are trusted to run dump trucks and bulldozers to do so. Students also use forklifts on a daily basis to learn how to move heavy cargo. Fairdale is the only school in Jefferson County with a heavy equipment science program. Brandy Corbin is the principal of Fairdale High School. She likes how this program prepares students for the real world.
What makes this program so special is the opportunity that the students have to get really hands-on experience using the equipment. We have equipment here on site, and they also get the opportunity to go out and use that equipment on real work sites. Some of them actually participate in internships and apprenticeships at different places, and so they get a lot of hands-on experience and are able to get jobs immediately out of high school with their skills.
Although getting projects done is a huge accomplishment, safety is their number one priority. They become eligible for this by working with student-built simulators in the classroom. Not only are the students working on projects in school, but they are also working at their jobs this program has allowed them to partner up with. Many seniors were eager to share how the Heavy Equipment Science Program works and how it will influence them in the future.
My name is Trezion Allen. I'm a senior, and I'm in Heavy Equipment Science. This class prepares us for after high school by teaching us responsibilities and expectations for on the job site.
My name is Will Probst from Fairdale High School, Heavy Equipment Science Program. This program helps me with the future because of the teamwork and the safety aspect of this.
My name is Skylar Sample. I'm a senior here at Fairdale High School in the Heavy Equipment Science Program. There are a few expectations for the program. You know, you must be ready to operate. You have to be ready to take this seriously because this is a place, you know, we're working in a workplace where people can get hurt. And I'm always grateful for what I've learned here in the program.
The Heavy Equipment Science Program at Fairdale High School gives the students the opportunity to get a head start on industry that needs young talent.
And for our kids, I'm Fern Creek correspondent Molly Wright.
We have more great stories about JCPS students. Stay tuned.
My name is Natasha Williams. I'm a bus driver for Jefferson County Public Schools. For me, it's all about the children. Because most parents work, I'm part of that working parent group. I'm usually the first person to say good morning to a child. And I don't take that for granted. I love that. During the over 12 years, I've seen some children grow up to be adults and have children of their own, and I get to pick up their children. When you meet bus drivers, you instantly have friends because we wave and talk to everyone. So if you're on a bus, you'll see all the bus drivers waving at each other. It's been great for me and for a lot of other bus drivers. I always tell them, just try it. If I can get them to stay 1 year, they'll stay a lifetime because it's a really good job. It's more of a calling for me. It's the right job. I'm Natasha Williams and I am JCPS.
Welcome back. You're watching Our Kids, sponsored by the Jefferson County Public Schools. I'm Ballard correspondent Maddie Sennett. Curtis Blow was a pioneering rap artist known for his hit, The Breaks. He recently visited Western Middle School and shared how his education laid a foundation for success.
Today we're at Western Middle School for the Arts, and today we have a wonderful hip hop artist coming to visit with us today, Mr. Curtis Blow. He's going to talk with a select group of kids about being in the music industry and all the ins and outs about it, and then we're going to have a big school-wide assembly.
Hello, everyone. You guys feeling good today?
Yeah.
Well, if you're feeling good, let me hear you say, oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So I wanted everybody to witness greatness. Several students are going to perform today, several student groups, and most of them have only had about 24 hours. One group only had about an hour to get something together.
There's a light in the darkness.
But what I tell them is that as performers and being at a performing arts school, we always have to be ready to perform. So it may not be perfect, but it will be something that they put their heart and soul in, and they're going to give it their all.
I watch a lot of music award shows, and I remember watching Beyonce and, you know, Destiny's Child, which Beyonce's my inspiration, but to see Destiny's Child perform for Michael Jackson and those celebrities, it kind of felt like that, because even though I'm not as big as her, just to be in front of a legend like him and just to perform and just to share my talent and to show him and what I can do is just amazing.
This is New York City, and I'm a young guy coming up. I'm not popular. Nobody knew who I was.
Being in a household where straight A's is number one. If I don't get straight A's, if I don't do right in school, then there's no music. You gotta focus on school first, and that's it.
I said, I need to have an advantage over all the rest of these guys, over all the competition. So I went to college.
To hear that from him, a legend, to know that school is what helped him, you know, get to the success that he's at, is just wonderful and just lets me know, just keep on going hard, keep on doing what you're doing, keep on getting straight A's, and, you know, to be like him.
I'll give you an example. My biggest song is a song called The Breaks. These are the birds. Break it up, break it up, break it up. Right? But that was an old philosophy, right? So the key here is to take an old song, flip it, and give it a new meaning, a new, you know, for the style of today.
It's a responsibility of them to project, you know, positiveness and inspiring young people and helping people.
All right, do we have any rappers in the house? Any MCs? Little singers, when you're writing songs, think about later on in life that, you know, you can play these songs for your grandchildren and not be embarrassed. Think about your future, you know.
When you're in that position, that is your job. That's why God gave it to you. That's why you're blessed.
Break to win, break to lose.
man, just an incredible youth movement we have here at this middle school right now. Incredible, great day.
The Women's March on Washington, D.C. raised awareness of women's issues. Correspondent Julia Koning attended the historic event.
So the morning of the march, we boarded a train to get to the Washington, D.C. Metro.
This is really not like a negative environment. Everyone's just here to, you know, unify, support each other.
I feel like if women, you know, really banded together, regardless of race, religion, I think it would be an unstoppable force, you know?
Would you love to let us, you know, you know?
I'm here to just show my support for my fellow human beings and just stand in solidarity with everybody.
Signs were passed out that supported an array of causes. People watched from windows, climbed in trees, and listened passionately to feminist speakers share their thoughts. As the march came to a close, the crowds were still lively and spirited. This adventure will forever be in my memories, and I believe it will go down in history.
Central High School's Law and Government Magnet students give us their take on the U.S. Supreme Court.
A significant lesson we had was on our judicial system. The Supreme Court is one of the most important systems we have in place in our government right now. Their decisions influence our day-to-day lives. An absurd fact that we learned is that approximately only 3% of the American people can name all 9 of the Supreme Court justices. Can you name all 9 of the Supreme Court justices? Because we can.
Without, for example, the Supreme Court, I would not be able to sit in front of you. I would not be able to use the same bathroom as some of you. And in some cases, some of us may not even be able to come here in this very building. As a student, I feel like I should know who these individuals are who've made such a big impact on all of our lives.
Congratulations to the latest Excel winner, Amy Hinton at Carter Traditional Elementary.
Congratulations. You are an Excel Award winner.
Thank you.
The JCPS Robo Rumble was an official Kentucky Derby Festival event this year and sponsored by IU Southeast. And congratulations to the Crosby Middle School cheer team. They take home the title of the 2017 state champions in the Super Large Division. They were undefeated this season. We also want to congratulate the gold medal winners of the 2017 Scholastic Art and Writing Awards. It's the nation's longest running and most prestigious recognition program for creative teens. Morgan Betzel of DuPont Manual won in 2 categories, mixed media and sculpture. Tiana Courtney of PRP won for ceramics. And Jordan Heller of Atherton High School won for drawing and illustration. Thanks for watching our show. We hope you enjoyed it. You can find full episodes of Our Kids on the JCPS YouTube channel. Until next time, keep supporting Our Kids.